Yes guys, I've bought myself a CNC machine. Last year I decided I wanted to add a CNC machine to my workshop tool count, and well, I looked around for a bit and it took a little while to find something suitable. Eventually I stumbled across the Ooznest Workbee, which seemed to be quite promising, a screw driven machine that was relatively inexpensive and affordable for a hobbyist like me. So I decided to check it out, watched a load of videos on YouTube about it, and spoke to my friend Q, who actually already owns one of these machines, and he only had good things to say about it. So, you know, with all that in mind, I decided to purchase one of these machines. I went for the 1000 by 750 millimeter machine, which fits in the corner of my workshop nicely. Now, it was a bit of a wait because I ordered this during Corona, and well, we're still basically going through Corona, but it took 4 weeks to get here. And in that time, I made myself quite busy by rearranging the workshop in here and building a table for the machine to sit on and go in that corner, which I screwed to the walls, and it's a nice solid platform. Now, when the machine eventually arrived, it came in three boxes, and that's because I bought the enclosure. So the machine normally comes in two boxes, one big square one and one sort of longer, thin one with all the extrusions in it. Now, the big square one is the pile of goodies. Opening that for the first time was just like amazing. There's so many boxes of different bits and pieces in there. The router's in there, the electronics are in there, all the nuts and bolts are in there. And just emptying that out onto the table I just built was amazing. Like looking at all the different parts, fantastic. And it's during this time that you realize initially that Ooznest have done an absolutely amazing job of labeling and packing all of these individual components, so that it's really easy to know what's what and where to find stuff when you need to get it for going through the build guide. So guys, I wanted to take my time building this machine. I put a bit of music on, chilled out, did a bit of filming, and slowly went through the excellent instructions that Ooznest provide for building this thing. Now, when you get your machine, they have a card in there that tells you the version number of the machine. Mine is version 2.1, which is like the latest one. And armed with that information, you go to their website. There's like a learning portal, and you just click on the version that your machine is. And in there are step-by-step instructions that take you all the way through a big pile of parts, all the way through to a fully tested and commissioned machine. Now, I've got to hand it to Ooznest. This online learning portal is an absolutely fantastic resource, guys. It's one of the big selling points for this machine, I feel, and it's something that I didn't really know that they did or thought they advertised widely. And I wish I did know this at the start, because it would have further cemented the fact that going with Ooznest is the way to do it. You've got this online learning portal, and it's like a combination of Lego and IKEA all together. And it just takes you through building the machine all the way through, from like just the first wheels that you put together, all the way through to attaching the carriages onto the extrusions and building it all up, and then doing the electronics, etc. All of that stuff is contained in this manual. It takes you all the way through it. And it has little boxes that allow you to tick when you've finished a certain section, so you know where you're up to. But more importantly, it has comment sections. Now, the instructions are 99% perfect. They were brilliant and I did enjoy them. But there was a couple of times where something was confusing, or there might have been a slightly better way to do it. And in that comment section, people who'd been there before me had written, actually, I did this, now's a good time to do this bit, rather than just attaching it straight onto there. Skip ahead to here and do that, then come back. There was a couple of bits of that in there which turned out to be really handy. The Z-axis end stop switch being one of them, which wasn't in the manual. When you were building the carriage, it's actually in the manual right at the end, and apparently it's a nightmare to get to at that point. So somebody had already taken the time to write in the comments their experiences and help me along, and it was really good to do that. And I left a few comments in there for people behind me also. I think that's a fantastic resource. Anyway, we built this machine up over a period of 3 days, and I really, really enjoyed it, guys. It was one of the most enjoyable things I've done for a long time. Like I said, I just kicked back, built it, I had all the tools I needed to do it. The only problem I encountered was I had to strip the insulation off one of my Vera hex keys to get it into the hole to tighten up one of the bolts. But apart from that, really easy. No tools were provided in the kit, which is another bit of a shame. I would have liked to have seen a couple of tools in there, or at least a list of tools of what you need on the website or something so you can buy them in advance. There's a couple of things that you might not have. I'd be surprised, but I had everything in here because I've got quite a comprehensive toolkit, but there'd be a couple of things that you might not have. It'd be nice to see a tool list. The only problem I had with building my machine up is the Y lead screws were a little bit too short. Now, that was super annoying because I just finished building the machine, go to tension the screws and realize I couldn't get the tensioner on the screws. It's a little bit too short. Super annoying. I did speak to Ooznest about it straight away, and it took about a week for them to get the parts out to me. In total, came in like two packages. But they did get the parts out to me, and I found out on Facebook later on that it wasn't the first time this had happened with the Y lead screws. So I was a little bit annoyed with Ooznest that they hadn't sort of checked that stock after the first time. But certainly once I brought it up to them, they said they were going to check everything and they were going to, you know, make sure they told all the people that had just bought kits to check theirs as well, because there was a chance there was more people with the same problem. So the customer service at Ooznest seems to be pretty good. Now, it's the only interaction I've had with them. There are people before me that have commented on the Facebook group and on the various forums saying the support is amazing. So I think you can buy with confidence from Ooznest. If you get a problem, they're going to sort it out. They certainly sorted me out, and you know, the machine's often doing its thing now, which is absolutely brilliant. Now, if you're like me and you've sort of mastered the 3D printing stuff, and you think you can just jump straight into CNC, then think again. I made that mistake, and actually there's a little bit more to CNC than there is to 3D printing. On the surface, it appears to be quite similar, but actually there's more stuff to learn, especially the Fusion 360 CAM stuff can be a little bit confusing for me. And it was at this point that I was really grateful to have my friend Q available on the phone. I had a couple of questions and he got me sorted out straight away, and the machine's been off cutting some awesome stuff. I can't wait to use this machine to make some amazing things. One of which, well actually the first thing I've cut actually, is this sign for my new business. It's only just for in here in the workshop, but it came out super well. You know, I'm really glad that it was basically hassle free. And I think that's a testament to not only how good the machine is, but also to how good you build it. If you spend time making sure it's all square, making sure everything's good, then you're gonna have a much better time when it comes to cutting stuff. And I was super impressed to get this straight off the bat, and I can't wait to like cut a load of new stuff with it, do a load of projects that I've not been able to do before with a 3D printer. It's a lot quicker to make stuff in subtractive manufacturing than it is to additive, so it's going to be a fantastic addition to the workshop. And I'd like to say that I can thoroughly recommend Ooznest if you're looking for an affordable hobbyist CNC machine like I was. Now, this isn't the only CNC video I'm going to do. I'm going to start doing some videos about this. We're going to upgrade this machine. We're going to add stuff on there, like the vacuum system, maybe a borescope, some other bits and pieces. It's going to be fantastic. I'm looking forward to like learning how to do this properly and taking you guys with me along the way. So if you're into that sort of stuff, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button below, and I'll see you guys on the next one.